Okay. Hi everybody. It's Wednesday again and we're here at the Aqueduct of Roquefavour. It's one of my special places. Cézanne has Montagne Saint-Victoire for him and I have the Aqueduct of Roquefavour because we live on this side of Aix. So it's always been my special place and my special thing. What I love about it is the tension created between the man-made arches that are so geometric and the tension that that creates with the organic stone that's created by our Creator with a capital C and the way the two come together. And so today I think I'm going to begin by concentrating on that tension of the two ways that creators work, man and God. Somehow that is exciting my inner poetry today. So we'll see what happens from that start. Off we go. Okay, I think it's stopping time. So it's the light is going away, and I've painted it as the sun was setting behind the distant hill. And I think this is what it is for today. It was fun. Thanks for watching.
Someone said, what colors have you used for those darks in the foreground and the trees?
Oh, the trees are, I often do have this mix that I use often, which is cobalt blue and raw sienna for these trees along here, and then for the trunks, and then for the grasses and the red, the shadows that I gave a red tone, it's the alizarin crimson. Sometimes I have alizarin crimson, sometimes quinacridone rose, but each time the color is broken with its complement to give it an organic color instead of straight out of the tube. So I used a lot of cobalt blue and a lot of raw sienna and some orange for those orange trees that are starting to take on the fall colors. Jimmy's gonna approach the camera to get a closer view of it before it gets too dark. And then we're gonna pack up and head home. Hang in there, he's coming.